had a bit of an issue with the rescue boat. So I was saying the air conditioning unit got kaput. Body fluid is, I think, gone, so I need to drink a lot of water. Good morning guys and girls, welcome back to another day at sea. I hope you're doing absolutely fine. Over here, I haven't had much of sleep last night, just maybe 3 or 4 hours, because the air conditioning unit...
10 miles, 4 and a half, 1 0 meters to come ahead,
1 0 meters.
0 meters.
Yeah, so I was saying the air conditioning unit got kaput, the motor burnt out, so we had absolutely no aircon, and it's Gulf. 45 degrees Celsius outside, and with the metal superstructure, it absorbs all the heat. My god, guys, it was like sleeping in your own sweat. It was terrible. So these are some of the challenges which we face, and we are tired, fatigued, lack of sleep, and still safety has to be priority, and you know, has to be kept in mind at all times. So yeah, so guys who keep asking me, you know, what are the challenges, what is everything, this is one of the biggest challenges of, you know, not being able to sleep and then conducting mooring stations and all of that with all safety. And yeah, so we are in the port of Abu Dhabi, just getting alongside the full, and the water is so blue, so blue, looks amazing. Oh, this is all the mud which is coming from the thrusters, and you know, it's going sideways. Have a look at that sky. And now we are alongside in Abu Dhabi Khalifa Port 5 and 2, and yes, it's so humid. It's like, again, I'm drenched in sweat. As it is at night, it was the same thing. So feels, you know, feels kind of that yuck kind of feeling, you know. It's all just this boiler suit is sticking around. So now we just go and let go the tug. So there's our tug. So we just got completed with the let going of the tugs. It's a beautiful port though. The sun is just shining out, and there's the second tug from the aft which is going now, and there's our tug which was in the forward and she's left, and there's a lot of tug movement. So this is a new kind of port.
When you go, you can put the gangway down, yeah? People are okay to come aboard.
Okay.
So now once we're alongside, like you heard the captain, we put the gangway down, so the stevedores, they come on board. Stevedores are basically guys who will unlash these lashings which I showed you in one of the videos. Bars are down now, and I'm waiting for the aft station. Once they finish the moorings, then I will put these winches on auto tension. You can have a closer look at the winches. This is the brake band, and this is where it has been engaged. Yeah, and that's the tension drum, the motor. 50% auto tension and springs on brake.
Aye, aye, very good, thank you.
You know, sometimes there are ships passing by, so it causes a surge. So the ship, you know, tends to move. So in order to hold that, the auto tension comes in very handy. And spring lines are basically for restricting the forward and aft movement. So we put on brakes.
What time departure on that?
Tomorrow 1900. Yes. So guys, it's not even finished, and these gantries have already started, you know, picking up the containers. So this is what I was talking about when I say we get very less time on container shipping, container ships. So yeah, that's the thing. Man over here, he is really tired.
Yes.
How much sleep you got last night, man?
Sleep? Maybe only 3 to 4 hours, because very hot from the air condition is
kaput.
Yes.
So like I said in the morning, guys, this is a really bad day today, because No sleep for all crew.
Yes, because
he's already drenched in sweat.
Yes.
Totally, you can see his face, all sweat. It's totally humid and doesn't feel so good, but well, that's how life at sea is, yes, right? So guys, that's the bus full of stevedores over here. And they will come and do the unlashing now. That's another bus. I have really low energy and all the, you know, body fluid is, I think, gone, so I need to drink a lot of water. But first I have to take the draft and the density, like the usual. That's the standard protocol. So guys, drafts are done. I think, I don't know if you can see it, but it's over there. And Emma, she's alongside. Beautifully. Beautiful blue. And now the sun does not appeal to me that much because it's so freaking hot. So guys, have a look at the crane booming down. It's pretty sight. You can see it. So guys, as you can see, it's almost at this level. So if they want to pass to the other side, you see these are masts, these masts are obstruction, so they need to boom up and then go aft and then boom down again. That's how it works. It's evening time, 6 o'clock, and we had a bit of an issue with the rescue boat, so we lowered it and now it's hanging and we are unable to retrieve it because one of the hydraulic hose, it's parted, so we have to improvise and lash it now. So let's see how we do it. And we lowered the lifeboats today. You know, it's Solas regulation to turn the lifeboat down and, you know, test it in the water. So now it's up. I missed it. Next time I'll show it to you guys for sure. And have a look at the view here. It's quite a pretty port, and yeah. Blue water, lush blue water. Brilliant, guys. But it hasn't been a very good port stay for us because the aircon was totally destroyed, and we just managed to fix it right now with an old compressor. So it's not that efficient. So let's see how the night goes. It's hot. So guys over here, they're trying to fix the hydraulic hose right now. But doesn't look so good. So we got chain blocks in case we just have to leave this David back. And that's the rescue boat still swinging. So it's been a long day, long tiring day for all the engineers for the deck side, and still we have to continue with this. So that's how tough life at sea is, guys. So yeah, it's not so easy.
That's why we bring this tip, this tip, so tip, just hold.
Guys, me and the team also, we are looking for a chain block now. It's taking a long time to repair this, and we're all really tired. You can see the amount of sweat. It's crazy. Guys are still working on it, trying to connect the hose. So let's see how it goes. We finished. Let's see how it goes now.
Up for up, then going out.
Did
you press
it?
I have to press
now. The chief also
healed
now.
Okay,
let's try.
Slowly, slowly, open it.
We managed somehow, but it's still leaking, so we put a tape around and guys are really happy, so yeah, it's good. So guys, finally we managed to get the rescue boat back in place with some temporary fix. Whew, it was tiring, and now I have some last minute paperwork to do. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Next will be, we have a long voyage till China now, so catch you guys up. So I'll catch up with you guys over there. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give it a thumbs up. Thank you guys. I thought I'd just give you a time lapse.